Hello everyone, let's learn today some extra examples. The length of rectangular room is 5 meter and its breadth is 3 meter. So what is given? Length and breadth of rectangular room is given. Okay, so right here given. Length is how much it is given? 5 meter. And breadth how much it is given? Breadth is given 3 meter. Length and breadth of rectangular room is given. Okay. Find the expenditure to paint. Suppose this is room. Rectangular room. Length and breadth is given. Okay. So find the expenditure to paint the roof. Okay. Find the expenditure to paint the roof of the room. Okay. Roof of the room. At the rate. And what is the rate? Rupees 12 per square meter. Per square meter, what is the rate? Rupees 12. Okay, so first we should know to find the area. So what we are going to do first? First, let's find the area of the room. Okay, then we can find the expenditure of the roof. Okay, first we need to know the area of the room. So let's find the area of rectangular room. Okay, area of rectangular room is equal to, okay, length multiplied by breadth. Room is rectangular shape. What is the formula for area of rectangle? Length multiplied by breadth. So what is the length? Length is 5 meter. And what is the breadth? Breadth is 3 meter. Okay, so 3 meter. So now 5 threes are 15. And what unit will write? It is its area. So area what we are doing? Square meter. Area we are writing square meter or meter square. Okay. So now we got the area of rectangular room. Now what it is asked in the question? We got the area of rectangular room. Now what it is asked? Find the expenditure to paint the roof of the room. At the rate rupees 12 per square meter. Per square meter, what is the rate? Per square. Per square meter. What is the rate? Rupees 12. We have to find the expenditure. No? So per square meter, what is the rate? This is given. Rupees 12. And now how much square meter area we got of room? 15 meter. Area of the room is 15. Means the roof of the area of the room is 15 square meter. So roof of the room is 15 square meter. So what we have to find per square meter? What are the rate? Rupees 12. Then for 15 square meter, how much? Then 15 square meter. What is the cost? Okay. For per square meter. Per square meter means for 1 square meter rupees 12. What is the expenditure? Per square meter rupees 12 is the expenditure to paint the room. Okay. Then for 15 square meter, we got how much square meter area? 15 square meter. So for 15 square meter, what are the charges? Okay. Means what is the expenditure? So let's multiply. So we'll get the expenditure. Okay. So expenditure to paint the roof of the room. So expenditure paint the roof of the room. What we have to do? What is the area? 15 square meter. Okay. And per square per meter rupees 12. So for 15 square meter we will multiply by rupees 12. Okay. 12 fives are 60. So 0 is here, 6 will be the carry. 12 ones are 12. 12 plus 6, 18. Okay. So rupees 118. Okay. So expenditure to paint the roof of the room is rupees 180. What it is asked in the question? Find the expenditure to paint the roof of the room. expenditure to paint the roof of the room is 180 rupees. Okay. So question number 2. The perimeter of a square is 44 centimeter. What is given? Perimeter of square is given. Okay. And what it is asked to find the area of the square. What it is asked to find the area of square. Okay. So now what we have to find area of the square. What is the formula for area of square? Area of square is equal to side multiple by side. What is the formula for area of square? Area of square is equal to side multiplied by side. And what is given? Perimeter of square is given. Perimeter of square is given and it is asked to find the area of square. Now, area of square, what is the formula? Side multiplied by side. Now, you will think, madam, here side is not given. Then how we will find the area of the square? Okay, so see, it's very easy. What is given? Perimeter of square is given. So write here a perimeter of square formula. Okay, perimeter of square. What is the formula for perimeter of square? See, we should know the side. Side is not given. See, to find the area of square, we should know the side. Then only we can find the area of square. But side is not given. But what is given? Perimeter of square is given. Perimeter of square. What is the formula for perimeter of square? 4 into side. 4 multiplied by side. This is the formula for perimeter of square. Okay. Now you will think again, madam, 4 multiplied by side came side. We don't know. But see, perimeter of square we know. It is given. Perimeter of square is 44 centimeters. So, down of perimeter of square, we have to write 44 centimeter. Okay. So, we know the perimeter of square. Now, we are able to find the side. What is the formula? 4 into side. See, this is the formula. Perimeter of square is given 44 centimeter. Okay. 4 into side is the formula for perimeter of square. Now this 4 is here. Multiply it. We will transfer to this side. Then it will become divide. See, this is 4 is for right hand side. If we will transfer 4 to the left hand side, then it will become divide. Why? Because it is here multiply. If we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become divide. So 44 divided by 4. Now what will remain here? Here will remain only side. Yes. 4 we transfer to the left hand side. So what will remain here? Side will remain here. So 4 ones are 4. 4 ones are 4. 4 ones are 4. So what we got? Side we got 11 centimeter. Okay. Side what we got? Side we got 11 centimeter. So right here, side is equal to 11 centimeter. Now we got side. Yes, now we got side of square. Now we can find the area of square. That is what we asked, na, to find the area of square. So what is the formula for area of square? See, it is given here. Area of square is equal to side multiplied by side. Now what is the side? Side we got 11 centimeter. Meter multiplied by 11 centimeter. Okay, so now 11, 11 is 121. If you know the square of 11, it is easy to write the answer. And if you don't know, do the calculation and write here. 121. Always, we find the area in the form of square. So write the unit square centimeter. Okay, so it is very easy question. See what is given in the question? Perimeter of square is given and it is asked to find the area of square. So to find the area of square, first what we did? Here, I have written the formula for area of square. Side multiplied by side. But side only we don't know. So how to find the side? We know perimeter of square. So write here perimeter of square formula. And with this way you will get the side. Once you got the side, you can find the area of square. Okay. So question number 3. The length of a rectangular ground is 100 meter. Okay. And its breadth is half the length. Breadth is Okay, what is given? The length of rectangular ground is 100 meters. So length is given. How much it is? 100 meter. Length of rectangular ground is 100 meter. Okay, and its breadth. Breadth, how much it is given? And its breadth is half the length. Breadth is half the length. See what it is given? Breadth is half the length. What is the half the length? Length is 100 and it's half. So divide by 2. Okay. What is the length? Length is 100 meter. And breadth, what it is given in the question? Breadth is half the length. Half, we have to make it half. Half means we have to divide by 2. So what will get the answer? 100 divided by 2? 50. So 50 meter we will get. See what it is given? The length of rectangular ground is 100 meter. And its breadth is half the length. Breadth is half the length. Length is 100. So breadth is 50 meter. Length is 100 meter. So breadth is 50 meter. Why 50 meter? Because it is given. Its breadth is half the length. Breadth is half the length. What is the half the length? Length is 100. So it's half. It is 50. Okay. So we got length and breadth. And what it is given? To find the expenditure of leveling the ground. We have to find the expenditure. Here what we have to do? We have how much we will spend to level the ground at the rate of 10 per square meter. That we have to find. So first we should find the area of the ground. It is rectangular ground. So we should know the area of the ground. Then only we can find the expenditure for leveling the ground. Okay. So first we should know the area of the ground. So area of rectangular ground is. What we have to find? Area of rectangular ground is equal to length multiplied by breadth. What is the area of rectangle? Length multiplied by breadth. So area of rectangular ground is equal to L into B, means length multiplied by breadth. So what is the length it is given? Length we have got. Length is given 100 meter. Length is given 100 meter. And what is breadth? Breadth is half the length. Breadth is half the length. So length is 100. So breadth is 50. So how much breadth is? 50 meter. Okay. So now find the area of the rectangular ground. 100 multiplied by 50. 0, 0, 0. 3 zeros. Count the number of zeros in multiplication. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 5 ones are 5. So, area. So, what unit we have to write? Square meter. What unit we have to write? Square meter. Okay. Area we get in the form of square. So, write the unit here. Square meter. Okay. Now, what it is asked after that? Find the expenditure of leveling the ground. So, now what it is asked? To find the expenditure of leveling the ground at the rate of rupees 10 per square meter. What it is given? Per square meter. Per square meter. What is the rate? Rupees 10. Per square meter, how much cost it is? Rupees 10. What is the expenditure per square meter? Rupees 10. And how much square meter we got? 5,000 square meter. What is the area of the ground? 5,000 square meter. So per square meter rupees 10. Then 5,000 square meter how much? For 5,000 square meter is equal. Means what are the charges for 5,000 square meter? For per square meter, for leveling the ground per square meter rupees 10. Then for 5,000 square meter, how much rupees? Okay, now we know for per square meter means for 1 square meter rupees 10. Then for 5,000 square meter, how much? So we need to multiply. Okay, so write here expenditure of leveling the ground. Expenditure of leveling
the ground. Is equal to what we will do for 5000 square meter. What is the area? 5000. Okay. For 5000, we will multiply by rupees 10. Okay. So what we will get? 5000 into 10. What we will get? 50000. Now see one number of zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 ones are 5. So 50000. So what are the charges? What is the expenditure? Rupees 50,000. So what it is as, find the expenditure of leveling the ground at the rate rupees 10 per square meter. So the expenditure of leveling the ground is 50,000 rupees. Okay. So question number 4. The length of a rectangular hall is 25 meter and its breadth is 12 meter. Okay, means length and breadth of rectangular hall is given. Okay, so find how many square tiles are required. See, how many square tiles are required to cover the rectangular hall if area of each tile is 3 square meter. What it is given for hall, how much tiles are required. Okay, to cover the hall, how much tiles are required. Okay, so for that, so what it is asked in the question, to cover the hall, how much tiles are required. Okay, miss, now what is given? Length and breadth of rectangular hall is given. The length of rectangular hall is 25 meter. It is given. Okay, and its breadth is 12 meter. Breadth is how much it is? 12 meter. And what it is given? What it is asked for? How many tiles are required to cover the rectangular hall? Means we have to find the number of tiles. Okay. If the area of each tile is 3 square meter. Okay. So what is given here? Area of each tile. Each tile. How much it is given? 3 square meter. Okay. Means suppose one room is, hall is given. Suppose one hall we have and that length and breadth of hall is given and area of one tile is given. Okay. One tile, what it is, suppose this is one of the tile. Okay. What is the area of this tile? It is given 3 square meter. Like this way, means this is the one tile area is given. So how many such a number of tiles are required to cover the hall? Okay, so one tiles area it is given, and like that way, how many tiles required to cover the hall, that we have to find. So first, for that we should know the area of hall. So let's find the area of hall. So area of rectangular hall. So here I will write the solution. These are the given things. Okay, area of rectangular hall is equal to, now rectangular hall, so what is the area of rectangle? Length multiplied by breadth. What is the formula for area of rectangle? Length multiplied by breadth. So what is the length? 25 meter. What is the breadth? It is given 12 meter. Breadth is 12 meter. Okay. So now let's multiply this. See, I will show 25 multiplied by 12. 12 fives are 60. Okay. 6 is carry. Here will come 0. 12 twos are 24. 24 plus 6, 30. So what we got? 300 square meter. What is the area? 300 square meter. Or you can write this way also, 300 meter square. This is also correct. Okay. So 300 square meter. What we got? Area of rectangular hall. So now I got the area of rectangular hall. Okay. Area of one tile. Each tile means one tile. What it is? 3 square meter. Area of each tile. Each tile is one tile. One tile area is 3 square meter. Okay. So to cover this hall, what is the area of hall? 300 square meter. To cover this hall, how many tiles are required? Okay, how many square tiles are required? See here, I will show you. So what we have to find? Number of tiles we have to find. Okay, how many square tiles are required? So number of tiles is equal to, so to get the number of tiles, what we have to do? Area of rectangular hall divided by area of square tile. Okay, area of rectangular hall divided by area of square tile. Okay, then we will get number of tiles. Area of hall we got, area of hall 300 square meter. Area of hall I got, I know the area of square tile 3 square meter. So how many like that with tiles are required? Say I will put 1 tile, 2 tiles, 3 tiles, 4 tiles, 5 tiles in that area. So how many tiles are required? So for that what we have to do? Area of rectangular hall divided by area of square tile. Area of square tile. Okay. So area of rectangular hall, how much it is? 300 square meter. Okay. 300 square meter. And what is the area of tile? 3 square meter. See, area of hall, how much it is? 300 square meter. And area of square tile? 3 square meter. Okay, so square meter get cancelled. Okay, so now 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 zeros are 0, 3 zeros are 0. So how much we got? 100. So number of tiles, how much number of tiles? 100. So what it is asked? Find how many tiles are required to cover the rectangular hall if area of each tile is 3 square meter. So the number of tiles are required? 100. So how many number of tiles are required? 100 to cover the hall. Okay. 100 tiles are required to cover the hall. You can write here. 100 square tiles are required to cover the